Señores, comenzamos a grabar. Welcome to your English class. Today is Wednesday, 8 December. My goodness. Wednesday first. I feel happy. I feel so happy because one of my favorite months is, in this case, December. I like it. Okay, before to start with the questions and before to start with the conversation, we are going to practice a little bit about grammar. This is the last exercise. Okay, can you please, Berito, me ayudas a leer el ejemplo literal A, por favor, Sally.
Sally has
Eyes.
eyes, they are green.
Okay, possessive, Sally's eyes are green. Thank you. Can you please, Daniela, letter B?
Dave is married. His wife is a doctor.
Muy bien, observe acá. Dave is married. O sea, está casado. His wife is a doctor. Su esposa es una doctora. Forma corta de decirlo, utilizando siempre las formas contractadas. David's wife. Miren, David's wife, la esposa de David. David's wife is a doctor. Ya en este caso, por ejemplo, David is married. Ok, David está casado. Lo que me pide el ejercicio es pasar a contracción la siguiente. His wife is a doctor. En vez de decir his wife is a doctor, fácil, David's wife, o sea, la esposa de David, is a doctor. Thank you. Franklin, can you help me to read letter C? My dad.
My dad had a revolution. It was successful.
Successful, excelente, un éxito. My dad had. Mi papá tuvo el qué? An operation, una operación. It was a successful. Y fue un éxito, forma contractada. My dad's operation was a successful. La operación de mi papá fue un éxito. My dad's operation was a successful. Thank you, Marcel. Letter D. Ian McQueen.
Ian McEwan has written a new book. It's very good.
Okay, Ian McEwan has written. Ha escrito el qué? A new book. ¿Y cómo es? Ah, it's very good. Forma contractada. Ian McGuire's new book, o sea, el libro de él. Ian McGuire's new book is very good. Thank you, José. Can you please letter E? I've got, yes, thank you, José. 5, 4, 3, 2. Renata, please, can you help me to read letter E? I've got.
I got a holiday at Easter. It lasts for 10 days.
Excelente. Hey, esta expresión, it last, anótela, porfa. ¿Qué significa cuando yo digo it lasts for 10 days? 5, 4, 3, any idea? 2, 1. It
¿Quería
lasts.
atrás? No.
It lasts for. No, Josecito, no te escucho, hijo. José, yes. It lasts for 10. ¿Qué significa esta expresión? It lasts
Es el
for.
último.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Este dura 10 días. It lasts. ¿El qué dura 10 días? El Easter. El Easter. ¿Eh? ¿Qué es Easter? ¿Qué season es? Sí, Easter. 5, 4, 3, Pascua. Pascua. Entonces dice, thank you, Edward. I've got a holiday at Easter. O sea, yo tengo vacaciones en Pascua. ¿Cuánto dura? Ah, it lasts for 10 days. Ok, ahora, ¿cómo quedaría en forma de más corta, por decirlo así? Easter's holiday. Teacher, ¿cuál es la diferencia entre holiday y vacation? There isn't any difference. No hay ninguna diferencia. Solo que vacation is used in American and holiday is used for British. So holiday and vacation are the same meaning and it has the same, well, yes, the same meaning in this case and the same translations too. Holiday, vacation, vacaciones. So Easter's holiday lasts 10 days. Thank you. Can you please, let's see, Giovanni, can you help me to read letter F? It was
a very boring lesson. It was yesterday.
Excellent. It was a very boring lesson. ¿Cuándo fue? It was yesterday. Yesterday's lesson, o sea, la lección de ayer, yesterday's lesson was very boring. Thank you. Miguel, please.
Me escucha.
Hoy sí, hijo lindo, ya cambiaste los audífonos, vea.
Sí.
Ok, ahí me ves con la letra H, porfa.
Ok.
Ok, Miguel, can you please help me with the letter G? Mr. and Mrs.
Mr. and Mrs. Davis have a house. It's over there.
It's over there. Hey, ¿qué significa eso cuando yo digo it's? Bueno, no digo yo, no, que sea aquí el ejemplo. It's over there.
Está a la
justo
par,
ahí.
Hey, no. Está ahí, ajá. Está justo ahí, está ahí. Excelente. Entonces, Mr. and Mrs. Davis, en este caso, Mr. and Mrs. Davis. House. La casa de ellos. It's over. Okay, Franklin. It's over there. Thank you. Letter H. Can you please, Jose?
Me. Derek sent me an email. It didn't say very much.
Okay. Derek sent me an email. It didn't say very much. O sea, el email no dice mucho. So, Derek's email, o sea, en este caso, el correo de Derek, didn't say very much. And the last one, letter I, can you please, Paola, somebody? Thank you, Paola. 5, 4. Three. Carmencita, please, can you help me to the last one? Letter I.
Somebody murdered a man. They mentioned it on the news.
On the news. Hey, ¿qué es este verbo? Murdered. Somebody murdered.
Asesinato.
Ok, muy bien. Somebody murdered a man. Asesinó, un verbo. Somebody murdered a man. They mentioned it on the news. Forma contractada. They mentioned a man's murder on the news. Con eso ya terminamos lo de las preposiciones. Recuerde que las preposiciones se pueden utilizar para hablar, hacerlas en una conversación o también como de una forma de gramática, no solamente es para escribirlas. Well, my dear students, we are going to continue with the question number 3. I like this question because you can practice hobbies, you can practice future plans, and also you can practice activities. The question is, what are you going to do tomorrow? Activity schedule. ¿Qué es un schedule? Es un horario, schedule. If you want, you can answer this question according to your personal opinion. Or if you want, you can invent. Teacher, do I need to present according to your example? No, this is just an example. If you want, you can say, teacher, well, tomorrow I'm going to blah, 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 blah. Or if you want, you can say, okay, teacher, tomorrow at 6:30 a.m., I'm going to watch the sunrise over the ocean. At 7:15 a.m., teacher, I'm going to have breakfast at any restaurant. At 9 a.m., I'm going to the museum. You can invent. If you want, you can say in a general way, o sea, una forma general, yo voy a hacer esto, esto, esto. Or if you want, you can use my example. Okay, teacher, I'm going to schedule. Voy a hacer un horario. You can invent. Do we have any volunteer who wants to start first? 5. 4, 3, to, my goodness, really easy. This is a
teacher.
Okay, thank you. Let's see. Jose number one, Berito number two, and yo creo que fue Carmencita la que activó el micrófono. En sí. Excelente. Okay, entonces, Jose one, Berito number two, Carmencita number three. Okay, please go ahead.
Ah, ya dicho, es que pensé que se iba a dar su ejemplo. Dice que
ah, no, 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 yes, please, ah. Right now.
Ok, tomorrow. Ay, uy, me escucha, teacher.
Perfect.
Ok, tomorrow.
Micro, excelente. Hoy sí, go ahead, please.
Es que no sé por qué me desconecté el audio. Pero
yo creo que tiene algún falso. Yo creo que si no te movieras tanto, hijo, tal vez el falso. Creo.
Okay, 7 o'clock. I have my breakfast. Then 9 o'clock. Complete my test of university. Then in the afternoon, I have my lunch. And I go to my class. Teacher, how do you say clases de manejo?
My driving classes.
My driving classes. And then I think take a nap with my sister. And in the evening, I have my dinner with my family and take a nap.
Okay, finish?
Yes.
Excellent. En este caso, si ustedes observan acá, dice, what are you? Excelente, José, lo hiciste muy bien. Ok, Eduardo, no te preocupes, hijo lindo. Te dejo de último. ¿Qué le estaba diciendo? Ah, sí. Tengo aquí en este verbo, en lo que se prepara Berito. Lo que me encanta de José es que José rápido dice las cosas claras y concisas. Y la verdad que es un inglés bastante fluido, que es lo que yo quiero que tengan todos. Ahora bien, la pregunta es, what are you going? Este verbo, going, tiene que usted introducirlo en su respuesta. ¿Cómo así, teacher? I'm going to, yo voy a. I'm going, por ejemplo, en este caso, ok, teacher, tomorrow I'm going to visit my grandma. And then I'm going to complete my university test. And then I'm going to have lunch with my family at X restaurant. And finally, I'm going to go to bed at 9 p.m. O sea, quiero que meta en este caso el going to. Ok, Berito, se prepara Carmen.
At 3 a.m., I get up, take a shower. 4 a.m., I breakfast.
Lo que acabo de decir, metamos el going to. At 3 okay. a.m., I'm going to get up. And then, at 3:30 a.m., I'm going to take a shower. And then, at 6 a.m., I'm going to have bread. Es el going. Okay, continue.
Okay. At 4 a.m., I'm going to breakfast and drink coffee every day. At 5 a.m., I'm going to work, sell newspaper. 9 a.m. I go to the bill in the bill bank newspaper.
Voy a pagar mi recibo. I'm okay. going to pay my bill. Voy a pagar mi recibo. ¿A dónde? I'm going to pay my bill at the bank. Fácil.
I go to bed.
Pay, el verbo pagar. Oh. Pay.
Pay, they will the bank.
Okay.
12, I prepare my lunch. 3 p.m., I go to the park.
I go to work
in the park. And 6 p.m., I prepare my dinner.
I'm going to prepare
my dinner.
Ok, thank you. Detalle, cuando vayamos a mencionar horas, por ejemplo, a las 6:30 yo voy a desayunar. At, la preposición at. At 6:30, no teacher, a las 7 voy a desayunar. Ah, entonces, at 7 a.m., no teacher, a las 8 voy a desayunar. Ah, ok, at 8 a.m., I'm going to have breakfast. Ok, vamos puliendo ya, señores. Ya vamos en nivel 4, ya el lunes iniciamos nivel 5. Pulamos. Carmencita, please, are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Ok, hey, teacher, ¿qué anda enojada? Miren, no es que ande enojada. Lo que pasa es que yo dije, para la clase de hoy, detallitos los voy a ir puliendo. Así que, mis amores bellos, esto es para que usted mejore su pronunciación, uno. Y segundo, para que vayamos puliendo estructura de oraciones. Ok, Carmencita, please, go ahead.
Okay. At 6 a.m., I'm going to do exercise. Then at 7 a.m., I'm going to take a shower. Then at 8 a.m., I am going to have breakfast. Then at 9 a.m., I am going to do my homework. Then I at 12 p.m. or a.m. I'm going to have lunch. And finally at 4 p.m. I'm going to go to the park with my family.
Okay. Usted puede, thank you, Carmencita. Usted puede decir, I'm going. La forma contractada, forma corta, am, o puede decir I am going, aunque yo prefiero la forma contractada porque la forma contractada se utiliza cuando el inglés ya en este caso se va puliendo y se va hablando de una forma más, ay, se me fue la palabra, no es profesional, más correcta por decirlo. Entonces usted puede decir I am going o puede decir I'm going to. Ok, natural. Yes, puede ser la palabra. Thank you, Edward. Volunteer, please. Bye.
Teacher.
Excellent. Marce, number one. Shirel, number two. Marce, what are you going to do tomorrow?
Okay. I'm going to the gym and down. When I come back home, I'm going to have breakfast, fried plantain, refried beans, and...
Paréntesis. I'm going to the, el artículo de, no es necesario. Voy a desayunar. I'm going to have breakfast. El I'm going to the, have, detallito chiquito. El de está de más. Ok, continue, hija.
I'm going to have breakfast, fried plantain, refried beans, and French bread. At afternoon, I'm going to beauty salon, do a
paréntesis. El at, puchica, teche, no nos va a dejar hablar. ¿Cómo no? Lo que pasa es que los quiero corregir. No se dice at afternoon. Ahí sería in the afternoon, porque el at solo se utiliza para las horas. A las 7, at 7, a las 10, at 10. Entonces ahí sería en la tarde, in the afternoon. En la mañana, in the morning. En la tarde, noche, in the evening. Ok, continue, hija.
Ok. In the afternoon, I'm going to the beauty salon to a cutting straightener. And finally, wow. In the every night, no, perdón.
At night, podemos decir, in the evening, perdón.
In the evening, I'm going to have dinner with my family. That's it.
Ok, excelente. ¿Saben lo que me gusta de Marce? Marce, cada vez que yo dejo este tipo de actividades, yo siempre escucho que ella mete una palabra nueva de vocabulario. ¿Cuál fue la de hoy, Marce? Que yo te dije, wow.
Straining.
Yes, excelente. Thank you, Marce. Ok, Shirel, are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Ok, wait a minute. Volunteer, please. After Shirel, volunteer, five, four. Excellent, se prepara Dani. Okay, Shirel, what are your plans? What are you going to do tomorrow?
In the morning, I'm going to receive class. the 7 a.m. Of 11 a.m. In the afternoon, I'm going to make a cake, and in the night, I'm going to see, I'm going to watch TV.
Okay, okay, excellent. Thank you so much. No mistakes. Nice. Dani, ready?
Well, tomorrow in the morning, I'm going to walk with my dog, and then I will give them their medicines. In the afternoon, I'm going with my mother to bring some photos for the university, and at night I'm going to see some Christmas movie with my family.
Okay, nice, excellent, no mistakes. Thank you. Volunteer, please. 5, 4, 3, 2. Daniela, can you please help me to choose? Elige una persona. Giovanni, Eduardo, Edward, Franklin, Hazel, Kenny, Miguel, Paola o Renata. Uy, yo siento que ya participaron un montón y me faltan un montón. Yes, Dani, please.
A mí, Dani.
Hoy sí, hija. Hoy no te dan de cenar, mira, hija. Okay, Kenny, ready?
Sí, teacher.
Mi modo, teacher, ya me eligieron. Okay, Kenny, please. What are you going to do tomorrow? Se prepara Eduardo.
Tomorrow morning, I will go to the supermarket for shopping. Mm-hmm. Para decir preparar.
Eso le iba a decir. I'm going to prepare. Voy a preparar.
Graduación, ¿cómo sería?
Ah, okay. Graduation. Uh-huh.
Graduation. Entonces sería graduation.
No, pero dígame mejor qué es lo que. Ajá, porque aquí sí ya nos fuimos por otro lado. Regáleme la idea, porfa.
Bueno, voy a preparar la cena de graduación.
Podemos, fíjense que lo podemos contractar. I'm going to prepare the graduation's dinner.
The graduation dinner. I'm going to prepare the graduation dinner.
Acuérdense que como es posesivo, graduation's dinner.
Graduation's dinner.
Uh-huh. Exacto. Okay. Uh-huh. Wow, finish. Nice. Okay. Thank you, Kenny. Eduardo, hi. Ready?
Hi, teacher. Yes.
Excellent. Se prepara Miguel. Eduardo, what are you going to do tomorrow?
Okay. Tomorrow, I'm going to wake up at 7 a.m.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to take a shower. And after, I'm going to the school. Also, I'm going to the park with my friends after school.
Mm-hmm.
And finally, I'm going to back home.
Okay, excellent. Okay, thank you so much. Me encanta cuando utilizan esa expresión finally. Y finalmente, yo voy a hacer eso. And finally, I'm going to blah, blah, blah. Okay, hi, Miguel. Are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Excellent. Let's see. Be ready, Renata. Miguel, what are you going to do tomorrow?
Tomorrow, I will do... Well, at 6 a.m., I wake up, and then I take a shower. At 7:15 a.m.,
mm-hmm.
I'm doing my breakfast, and then at 9 a.m., I do my homeworks. And then at 2 p.m. I will do my exercise. And finally at 5 p.m. I go out with my friends.
Okay, thank you so much, Miguel. Nice pronunciation. Excellent. Okay, Renata, are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Perfect. Se prepara Giovanni Guzman. Okay, Renata, what are you going to do tomorrow?
I 6:30. Teacher, ¿cómo se dice tomar?
Pero tomar agua o tomar el tiempo o tomar clase.
Tomar el desayuno.
Ah, I'm going to have my breakfast.
I go to have my breakfast. Take a shower.
Take a shower.
Take a shower and make my bed. At 10 past 9. I had a snack.
I'm going to have a snack.
I go to have a snack and took my dog to the park.
I'm going to take, porque es presente. I'm going to take my dog to the park.
Then I go to a square to buy things for my hamster and my dog. At 6:60, I might.
At 6, porque 60 es 60. At 6.
At 6, I prepare my dinner.
I'm going to prepare.
I'm going to prepare my dinner and prepare my bed. To finish at 8, I go to the pool to swim in for a week with my cousin and friends. That's it.
Finish?
Yeah.
Ok, thank you so much, Renata. Renata, en tu caso lo que tenemos que practicar es la, no, fíjate que no es la pronunciación, es la articulación de palabras. Teacher, ¿cuál es la diferencia entre pronunciar y articular? Pronunciar es cuando yo digo, my name is Gabriela, I live in Santa Tecla, I'm an English teacher. Pronunciación correcta. Articular incorrectamente es esto. My name is, Santa Tecla. Thatcher. Articular es cuando usted abre su boca y articula las palabras. Si usted me habla de esta manera, yo no le voy a entender. Entonces usted tiene que articular. En el caso tuyo, hija, pronunciación tenés, pero tenemos que trabajar la articulación. Abrir, en este caso, nuestra boca y utilizar muy bien cada palabra. En este caso, a veces los alumnos tienen buena articulación, pero no tienen buena pronunciación. Y hay alumnos que no tienen ni buena articulación y tampoco tienen buena pronunciación. Y hay alumnos que tienen las dos habilidades muy buenas, pero hablan demasiado rápido. Entonces, son cosas que hay, que en este caso en el lenguaje, en todos los idiomas, tenemos que aprender a articular y también tenemos que aprender a pronunciar. Si usted quiere aprender a pronunciar, escuche música en inglés. Si usted quiere aprender, en este caso, a articular, vea videos de fonética, la pronunciación de las vocales, la pronunciación de las consonantes, etcétera, etcétera. Entonces, articular, hija linda. Giovanni, are you ready?
Teacher.
Yes, Miguel.
I will return in a moment, just I have to do something.
Okay, nice. Thanks for letting me know. Nice, don't worry. Jova, hi.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, Giovanni, what are you going to do tomorrow?
What did you at 9:30 in the morning?
Fíjate, hijo lindo, que escucho más la bulla del fondo que a ti. Si quieres, te dejo de último. Te dejo de último, no te preocupes, no te preocupes, te dejo de último. Ok, Franklin, yo sé que always ready. Yes, Franklin, yes. Franklin. Yes, excelente, yes. Se prepara. Bueno, a Paola la llamé hace ratito y no me contestó. Así que let's see... Edward, nos preparamos. Ok, Franklin, what are you going to do
antes
tomorrow?
Antes de empezar, teacher.
Yes.
Como, have you said, have you said the...
What?
La palabra que le mandé en el chat.
Ah, ok, voy. Bury. Bury.
Bury.
Yes.
In the morning, I am preparing the place of the graduation of my cousin. Uh-huh. And in the afternoon, they will bury my friends, and I will go to the accompany the family. And in the night, I'm not sure that I do.
Okay, that's it?
Yes.
Okay, thank you so much. Hey, teacher, what does it mean, that word, bury? Bury. Any idea? 5, 4, 3... Se los mando ahí, enterrar. Okay, thank you so much, Franklin. Nice. Let's see. Hi, Edward. Are you ready?
Hi, miss. Yes,
excellent.
I'm ready.
Excellent. Hey, si se me queda alguien. Hazel, creo. Hazel, nos preparamos. Okay, Edward, what are you going to do tomorrow?
Well, tomorrow I'm gonna do the same things that I did today. And in the morning, I'm gonna wake up at 7 a.m. because this week I'm waking up more early. Before this week, I was waking up at 10 a.m. or 11 a.m. And at 1 p.m. I'm gonna watch anime. At 3 p.m. I'm gonna play video games alone. Oh, I forget something. At 9:30 a.m., I'm gonna play Minecraft with my friends.
Nice.
And at 11 a.m., I'm gonna watch videos on YouTube. Yep, that's it.
That's it. Excellent. Thank you so much. Hey, teacher, yo escuché que Edward dijo, I'm gonna. Ok, Paolita, ya voy contigo, mi amor. Teacher, yo escuché que Edward dijo, I'm gonna. En este caso, ¿cuál es la diferencia, teacher, de decir I'm gonna a decir I'm going to? There is only one difference. I'm gonna, it's informal, but it is also correct. And I'm going to is more formal. So both options are correct. Number one is informal, and the second option is formal. What can I, teacher, what, which option can I use? Whatever you want. If you want, you can use option one, or if you want, you can use option number two. Nice. Thank you so much, Edward. Let's see. Hazel, are you ready?
Always, teacher.
Perfect. Se prepara, Paola. Hazel, what are you going to do tomorrow?
Tomorrow, in the morning, I'm going... room in the park. Be after I'm going at my house. After I'm going to eat at restaurant for my lunch. After I prepare my dinner in my home, I prepare I prepare beer. After I go into a sleep. That's
nice.
It, teacher.
Okay, thank you so much. Teacher, how can I say tomarme el día libre? I'm going to take the day off. Day off es, en este caso también tiene el significado de día libre. O sea, ese día yo no trabajo. Day off. Día de descanso. Day off. Me voy a tomar el día. I'm going to take the day off. Excellent. Thank you, Paulita. Ready?
Hi, teacher.
Excellent. Y termino con Giovanni. Okay, Pau, what are you going to do tomorrow?
Okay. I think I'll go to my dad's work. That's it.
Okay. Paulita, teníamos que ir un poquito más, hija, para practicar vocabulario, okay? Un poquito más para la próxima, hija. Jova, are you ready?
Okay, teacher.
Okay. Giovanni, excellent. Okay, Giovanni, what are you going to do tomorrow? Contigo finalizo esta dinámica. Bueno, esa pregunta.
What I do at 9:30 in the morning. I get up at 10 at breakfast. Tomorrow at 11, I shower at 1 in the afternoon.
Mm-hmm.
As my lunch and the 3:30 in the afternoon, we clean up. And 6, we have dinner and at 9 or 11 night, we fall asleep.
Nice, excellent. Thank you so much. Miren, a mí lo que me gusta de Giovanni, que a veces sí, lo siento como que está ocupado, pero cuando participa, lo haces muy bien. Imagínate, hijo, si estuviera más enfocado, no, hombre, sería genial. Excelente, Giovanni. Muy bien. Vamos con la siguiente pregunta. Which country would you like to visit? Esta pregunta es súper fácil, solamente que quiero que vea los tres ejemplos que tengo acá. Usted puede contestar como usted guste, pero yo quisiera que usted comenzara como a utilizar más un inglés más fluido. Por ejemplo, which country?
I'm back to church.
Okay, thank you, Miguel. For example, which country would? Would. Te gustaría. No te estoy diciendo qué país vas a visitar. No. Te estoy preguntando qué país te gustaría. Bueno, que esta pregunta no la hice yo, ¿verdad? Pero te están preguntando qué país te gustaría visitar. Entonces, pueden ser tres opciones. I would like to visit. A mí me gustaría visitar. Por ejemplo, I would like to visit New York. O, por ejemplo, usted puede iniciar. Teacher, yo tengo muchas opciones. I have many options. I have many options. Y por ejemplo, usted puede decir, my first option is. Yo tengo muchas opciones y la primera es. Por ejemplo, en este caso, les voy a dar acá. Okay, which country would you like to visit and why? I have many options. My first option is Rio de Janeiro. Because, acuérdense que me tiene que dar una razón. Because I like the gastronomy. Por ejemplo, un detalle. I like the gastronomy. My second option is New York. Because New York is my favorite city. And also, my grandma, por ejemplo, si usted quiere inventar que su abuela vive en Nueva York. And also, my grandma lives in New York. Acuérdense que aquí es de inventar, se los he dicho muchas veces, pero ustedes se me siguen limitando con su respuesta real. O sea, teacher, yo quisiera visitar Honduras porque me gusta. No, hombre, practique vocabulario, porfa. O sea, usted se me está limitando. Entonces, usted invente. My third, para terminar. And finally, my third, y mi tercera opción. And finally, my third option is London. Because, y sigo con el would, because I would like to go to the Eiffel Tower. Eiffel Tower, la Torre Eiffel. Entonces, usted puede iniciar con, okay, teacher, I would like to visit Mexico. Because I would like to go to Cancun. Because I like the beach. Thank you. Okay, teacher, I have many options. Number one. O number two, o number three, o puede iniciar mi primera, my first option, mi segunda, my second option, and finally, my third option. Okay, volunteer, please. Excellent. Jose, yes, Jose, right? Jose number one, Shirel, yes. Number two, Veronica, number three. Okay, Jose, which country would you like to visit?
Okay, in my case, I would like to visit new country. French for the food is so delicious, or I think it's so delicious. And Portuguese, how do you say Portugal? Teacher in English?
Portuguese es el idioma, en este caso, okay. Portugal, yes.
Okay, Portugal, because the culture and the dance, I think, is samba.
Yes, it is. Brazil.
Yes, mm-hmm. That's it.
Okay, Eita, hay samba en Portugal.
I think it's the...
Can I go next, teacher?
Okay, nice. Well, I think que Jose number one, Shirel number two, Berito number three, Miguel number four. Okay. Sí, me quedé confundida, pero igual. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Jose.
Samba.
Yes, I don't have any idea, but I think samba is from Brazil, right? Samba, yeah. Yes. Okay, pero como aquí es practicar, hijo, no importa. Thank you. Okay, Shirel, please, what's your opinion? Mm-hmm. Se prepara Vero.
For me, it would be everyone, but the first country that I like to visit is New York, because I like to know my uncle.
Mm-hmm.
And the second option is Los Angeles, because here lives
¿Cómo digo ahí, teacher? There.
Because there live my aunt.
Okay.
And the other option is Mexico, because I like the Mexican candies.
Yes, nice. Uh-huh. Hey, me gustó una expresión en lo que se prepara Berito. It will be. Teacher, podría ser, it will be, excelente. Me encanta cuando utilizan nuevas expresiones. Teacher, ¿y cómo es que se da cuenta? No sé, gracias a Dios como que la memoria todavía no me falla. Pero me encanta cuando utilizan nuevas expresiones. Por ejemplo, Shirel, hey, teacher, it will be, podría ser, I love it, nice. Berito, se prepara Miguel.
I would like to visit Australia and Alaska. No, sorry, Canada, because no kangaroos and koalas. Also visit my friends Marielos Peña and Joseph Peña. Also Canada, because no the snow.
Ok, excelente. Podemos ocupar, fíjate, me gustaría ver a los canguros. I would like to see the kangaroos. Me gustaría ver la nieve. I would like to see the snow. Thank you, Berito. Miguel, are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Ok, please, what's your opinion? Which country or city would you like to visit?
Well, in my case, the country I would like to visit is New Zealand, because the Harry Potter's movie are filmed in this country.
Mm-hmm.
And my second one option is maybe Canada.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's too, I don't know, it's too cold and I like cold.
Okay.
And the third one,
mm-hmm.
the third one, yeah.
Yes, of course.
Is Mexico, because I like the gastronomy of Mexico.
Nice, excellent. I like it too. Thank you, Miguel. Okay, please volunteer 5, 4, 3. Okay, Carmencita number one, Daniela number two. Okay, Carmencita, what's your opinion?
Okay, I have many options.
Mm-hmm.
My first option is Rome, because I like the history on the Coliseo Romano.
Mm-hmm.
And my second option is Paris, because all the places are
beautiful there, and a friend lives there. And my third option is Mexico, because I love the gastronomy and I would like to eat tacos.
Okay, nice. Te mando una palabra, hija. Espérame, que la estoy escribiendo. Coliseum. Ahí está. Coliseo, el Coliseo Romano. El Coliseo. Roman, ahí me comí la N. Roman Coliseum. Roma Coliseum.
Roman Coliseum.
Excelente, muy buena pronunciación. Muy bien, thank you. Dani, what's your opinion, please?
Okay, teacher, I would like to visit Australia because it's very many attraction that I would.
Porque hay muchas atracciones. There are many attractions.
There are many attractions that I would love to visit, for example, the DreamWorks Theme Park, the Irwin Zoo, or the to be able to visit the University of Sydney. And I would also love to visit Greece, now Athens, and be able to try Greek food.
Okay, excellent. Greece. Excellent. Ellos siempre han querido ir a Atenas también. ¿Será caro ir a Atenas? Ya vamos a averiguar. Thank you, Dani. Sí, hombre, nos vamos en bus. Thank you, Dani. Volunteer, please. Teacher, yo quiero aprender inglés. Ok, participe. Ok, Marce, go ahead, please.
Me, teacher.
Ok, Marce, number one, and Giovanni, number two. Marce, which country would you like to visit and why?
Ok. My first option is Peru.
Option?
My first option is...
Con P.
Option.
Excellent. Muy bien.
Option is Peru, because I want to know Machu Picchu. I find that place very interesting.
Interesting. Podemos decir, fíjate, es un lugar interesante. Es un lugar muy interesante porque escuché que tú usas very. It's a very interesting place. El adjetivo va primero. It's a very interesting place.
Okay. It's very interesting place. And also, I would like visiting Germany because over there is Neuschwanstein Castle and it sounds very attractive.
Attractive. Excellent. Thank you, Marce. Giovanni, what's your opinion, please? Se prepara Eduardo.
My opinion and the countries that I would like to visit will be Italy, Argentina, and France. For the third quarter full and to know the soccer stadiums where the World Cup and Euro Cup were held, the biggest soccer events.
Okay, nice, excellent. Thank you, Yoba. So usual, perfect. Eduardo, what's your opinion? Se prepara Edward.
In my opinion, I would like to visit New York because I think it's movies icon. And then I would like to visit New York because Spider-Man was recorded. And I would like to see the Statue of Liberty. Liberty Statue.
Okay, excelente. Hey, otra forma de decir grabada, o sea, la película fue grabada. Filmed. Es un verbo regular porque solo le agregas ed cuando lo pasas a pasado. Filmed. Okay, thank you, Dardo. Hi, Edward, are you ready?
Yes, miss, I'm ready.
Perfect, be ready, Franklin. Okay, Edward, what's your opinion?
Okay, I have many options of country. Of countries, my first option is Japan, because I like anime and manga, and I would like to buy physical manga, because I read digital manga, but I want to have the collections of mangas. So I want to travel to Japan by that reason, but I need to learn Japanese. So I have a long way to visit Japan, and I would like to travel to Germany because I like the history of the war, the Second World War, and Germany was one of the most important members of the Second War. And I would like to visit places that were important on the war. Yeah, that is my reason.
Wow, nice.
I would like to travel to French, and to London, because that places were the most affected by the war.
Wow, nice, excellent. Hey, do you like to read about history?
Yes, but only is about war.
Okay.
I don't have a special attraction for that topic.
Okay, nice, excellent. Thank you, Edward. Perfect. Okay, hey, I forgot. I said yes. I didn't mention no one, right?
Me.
Okay, yes, Franklin, please.
Me.
What's your opinion about it? Se prepara, Paola.
Well, in my case, I would like to visit two countries. The number one in principle is Mexico, because I love the Mexican food, the gastronomy, the adios hay costumbres.
The customs. Or traditions.
The tradition and others. And I would like to visit the United States, because I would like to go see a Lakers game.
Nice.
Okay,
that's it.
Yes.
Okay, thank you so much. Pao, nos quedamos ahí. Señores, finalizo con la última pregunta. Teacher, yo no participé con la pregunta 4. No se preocupe, que igual por el tiempo. Pregunta 5. Which places in El Salvador have you visited? Voy a iniciar con Paola esta pregunta. Pero antes de que ella me dé en este caso su opinión, quiero que observe acá dos cosas. Tengo acá, have you visited? O sea, ¿cuáles lugares o qué lugares en El Salvador has visitado? O sea, la pregunta está en presente perfecto. Have you visited? O sea, ¿qué lugares de El Salvador has visitado? Entonces, usted no me puede decir, I would like to visit. A mí me gustaría. No, porque te está preguntando que ya has ido y te gustó ese lugar. No puedes responderme, I will visit. No, porque no te estoy preguntando qué lugares vas a visitar. La pregunta es, ¿qué lugares has visitado? Yo tengo tres opciones de respuesta. I have visited. Yo he visitado. Teacher, yo he visitado el Pital. I have visited the Pital. Teacher, yo he visitado las cascadas de Don Chepito. Teacher, I have visited las cascadas de Don Chepito. Digamos que es un nombre propio. Teacher, yo he visitado la playa El Tunco. I have visited the Tunco Beach. O también usted puede responder, I went to visit. Yo fui a visitar. Yo fui a visitar el volcán de Izalco. I went to visit the Izalco volcano. I have visited many places. Yo he visitado muchos lugares. Number one, number two, number three. Oh, En este caso, I have visited many places. For example, yo he visitado muchos lugares. Dice, por ejemplo, I went to, yo fui a, I went to the beach, el Cuco. In this case, I went to the Cocoa Beach. I went to, uy, yo he ido a tantos lugares que se me ha olvidado. I went to Cerro Verde. I went to the Tunco Beach. I went to, uy, cuántos lugares ahí se me han olvidado, señores. The National Zoo, por ejemplo. Entonces,
Ataco.
Ataco. I went to Ataco. I went to Apaneca. I went to Salcuatitán, etcétera, etcétera. Entonces, usted puede responder, I have visited. Ah, yo he visitado. O I went to visit. Yo fui a visitar. O I have visited many places. Yo he visitado muchos lugares. For example, number one, number two, number three. Entonces, la persona que vaya participando se va saliendo del aula virtual. Así que aquí voy con voluntarios. Volunteer number one.
Me, teacher.
Franklin number one. Okay. Voy a asignar números y a mí se me va a olvidar.
¿Me quieres agregar más?
Okay. Está Pau. Pau, ¿con quién estás? Con tu mami, hija. Okay, voy a asignar números, a mí se me van a olvidar. Franklin number one. Miguel number two. José number three. Shirel number four. Carmencita number five. Marcela number six. Six. Hasta ahí me quedé. Ok, los demás me hacen una pausa, porfa. Ah, y aquí Giovanni también, number eight. Espero que, ok. Voy con el número uno, please. Which places in El Salvador have you visited? Number one.
Well, in my case, I have visited many places. For example, I have visited...
¿En plural? Many places.
Many places. For example, I have visited... Taco. I have visited the Balkan. That is very funny for me. Yeah. I have visited the Green Hill. I have visited the I have visited the Takachico.
Okay, that's it. Thank you, Franklin, for yes. the time. See you on Bye. Friday. Thank you. Miren, que ya por el tiempo los voy a cortar. Number two, please.
Well, in my case, I visit a lot of places. Uh-huh. And the first one will be Ataco, the Ataco City and Ilopango. Lago, I don't know how to
lake.
Say Lago.
Lake.
Lake, Ilopango Lake. And El Pital, La Casa de Cristal in I don't know,
The Crystal House in the Crystal Cerro House.
Uh-huh. And the Tunco Beach.
Mm-hmm.
And the pier in the Union. In La Union, the pier.
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
Thank you so much. See you on Friday, number three.
See you.
Okay, number three. Edward, puedes inventar, hijo, no te preocupes. Hey, number three.
Me, teacher.
Okay, Jose, go ahead.
Espera. Que se me olvidó como que. In my case, I have visited many places,
mm-hmm.
Only with my family. For example, the Devil Door and the Ilopango Lake and the beach. For example, the Tunco. And no more.
Okay, nice. Thank you so much. Number four.
I only one visit. The volcano de Ilamatepec.
Ilamatepec volcano.
Ilamatepec volcano. The Cobanos Beach. Las Veraneras. Aco. That's it.
Ok, thank you. Nos vemos el viernes. Number Bye. Five. Who's number five?
Me.
Okay, Carmencita, go ahead.
Last month, I went to visit Costa del Sol Beach. That's it.
Excellent. Thank you. Perfect. Okay, se los perdono por el tiempo. Okay, sí. Next. Number six.
Me, teacher.
Okay, Marcelita, go ahead.
Okay. In my case, I have visited many places. For example, I went to visit Beach. Mm-hmm. I have visited Cerro Verde.
Mm-hmm. Un nombre propio.
And also, I have visited Coatepeque's Lake. Lago de Coatepeque.
Yes, Coatepeque's Lake. Thank you, Marce. Next. See you on Friday. Okay, next, I think Giovanni, no? Okay, well, volunteer.
Yes, teacher, me.
Ah, okay, Giovanni number one, Paola number two, Renata number three. Muy bien. Giovanni, please, go ahead.
The places I have visited in El Salvador is Oroquilta, Devil's Gate, mm-hmm. Apulo, Sor City, and the Divine Savior of World, Aguacaliente, among another.
Okay, thank you, Yova. Nos vemos el viernes.
Thank you, teacher. Thank
Next.
You.
Next. I think, Paola, please go ahead.
The place I have visited are Los Cobanos, the Port of Fredon, the Tabor of the World, the Root of Flowers, Ataco
City. Yeah. Uh-huh.
I'm sorry. The Lake of the, on the Costa del Sol, Hilo Vasco, the Volcano, Volcan of San Salvador.
San Salvador Volcano.
San Salvador Volcano. That's it.
Okay, esa era tu pregunta, Bea Pao.
Yes, teacher.
Ya ven que tengo buena memoria. Okay. Thank you, Renata, please. Your opinion.
See you Friday.
Bye, see you.
I have visited the volcano Izalco, the Green the Decameron, the plan
wow.
of the Lagoon, the Boquerón, and Ataco.
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
Okay, thank you, Renata. Okay, señores, una persona más porque van a disculpar, pero llevo otra clase.
Me, teacher.
Okay, Hazel, finalizo contigo, please. Go ahead.
Okay. I have visited the Flowers Road attack, and I would like to visit Volcatenango. That's it, teacher.
Okay, excellent. Thank you so much. Para los que me quedaron pendientes, si gustan, acuérdenme el día viernes, y yo con muchísimo gusto vuelvo a repetir esta pregunta. Van a disculpar, pero es que llevo otra clase. Señores, nos vemos el día viernes. Gracias a todos los que se con... Miren, me encanta porque ustedes son un grupo que son bien buzos, en serio. Practiquemos pronunciación, articulación, aunque aquí ya la mitad ya se salió, pero igual. Señores, nos vemos el viernes. Bye.
Bye, teacher.
Bye, teacher. Bye, teacher.